Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergy. Sleep is one of the few constants in our lives. Everyone does it, whether we like it or not. To some, sleep is simply a waste of time that could be put to better use. To others, sleep is a haven, a time of safety, and sometimes a time of dreaming. But why is it that we dream? Do these visions have a function, or are they just a happy or nightmarish side effect of sleep? Let's explore. If you want more science videos, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. But first, get ready, it's time to ask the question, why do we dream? This is a very difficult question, particularly considering sleep itself is largely mysterious to us. We know that sleep allows us to consolidate and solidify memories, rejuvenate our body, repair damaged tissue, synthesize hormones, and grow muscle, but we just aren't certain why just about all life on Earth has evolved to do it, particularly considering how defenseless we are while we sleep. Some believe it was to conserve energy and minimize the necessary caloric intake, others believe it was to avoid predators, but the fact remains that sleep is necessary to our bodies. However, things get even stranger when we look at what our brains are doing while we sleep, and why we're shown strange visions that we call dreams. Before we discuss why it is that we dream, we should probably discuss how it is that this occurs. As we sleep, our body cycles between a number of stages. Throughout the night, we transition from light sleep to deep sleep, and then to rapid eye movement or REM sleep, before starting the cycle once again. Most dreaming takes place in the REM stage, named for the movement of the eyes during this time. The average person has 3 to 6 dreams a night, although 95% of dreams are forgotten by the time you get out of bed. At this stage, our heart rate and breathing rate increase, sometimes with certain irregularities. This is also when some experience sleepwalking and bedwetting. This stage sees heightened, desynchronized brain waves that are similar to those seen while one is awake, which explains why dreams can often feel very much like they are real. When awoken during this stage, you're more likely to remember the dream you were having than waking up at the conclusion of the sleep cycle. So now we know something about how dreaming works, but do we know why we do it? Sadly, as with so many of life's biggest questions, the reason for dreams is largely a mystery to us. There have, however, been a number of ideas put forth that have some evidence supporting them. Some believe that dreaming helps us to interpret and remember information we took in during the day. This is largely based on studies that found that individuals that were taking a language course during a dream study dreamed significantly more than those not in the course. However, there are a number of alternate explanations for this. For instance, it could just be that those in the language course had more on their mind, which expressed itself as dreams, rather than the dreams being of any particular use. Others think that dreaming is a way to work through difficult emotions and experiences. The findings that dreams tend to be related to important stressors and events in one's life support this idea, although many alternate explanations exist. Furthermore, it's been found that those under significant stress have more dreams and more powerful ones, leading some to think that dreaming can help our brains to sort through various problems and even work to solve them. Again, however, the causation is not clear. Still, others believe that dreaming is simply the brain's response to the various biochemical changes and electrical impulses that happen while we sleep. This position would hold that dreams aren't particularly meaningful and are simply random firings in the brain. But science does not have the monopoly on ideas about dreams. For centuries, members of various religions have claimed to understand why it is that we dream. Some believe these dreams to tell of past lives and experiences. Others believe that people and objects in dreams can have symbolic importance to one's life. There are even some people, some might say charlatans, who claim to be able to interpret dreams, claiming that they can predict the future or tell things about the person that they may not be aware of. While some of these ideas are more scientifically supported than others, we don't know for sure which is correct. It could even be that several ideas around dreaming are correct and that it plays a number of roles in our well-being. However, until progress is made in dream research, we'll be stuck making educated guesses like these. Before we wrap up, there's one phenomenon that could use some love: nightmares. Nightmares can be caused by a number of things. Changes in diet, new medication, or increased levels of stress sometimes cause people to experience bad dreams. Those suffering from certain mental disorders like depression tend to have more nightmares as well. Personally, when I was younger, drinking too much water before bed all but guaranteed a visit from the lady with the long horns or the terrifying warblers. Yeah, I was a weird kid. Sadly, while we understand the stressors that can bring about nightmares, we're still hamstrung by our limited understanding of dreams themselves. And now we return to our question, why do we dream? Well, we aren't exactly sure. We have an understanding of the mechanisms that cause one to see images, but we don't know why this occurs, nor the significance of these visions. It could be that it helps us consolidate our memories or process our emotions. Our dreams may tell us things about the past or even the future, or it could be far less interesting than that. Dreams could simply be our brain spitting out images as it goes through the biochemical and electrical changes found during sleep. As of now, we can't know for sure, but my goodness, is it interesting. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know the strangest dream you've ever had. I once went on a quest to collect keys from Mother Nature, only to have my brains leached out of my head by the evil brain sucker. Ouch. Until next time, I'm Ron Mackenzie Lafergy with Life's Biggest Questions. Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.